Good morning to everyone. In the last class, we have discussed about internal tables and work area. Now, how can we display the data from the internal table? Okay, and yesterday I missed to explain about this date field. Okay, here I am passing something date, document date is there. I am passing something 15-7-2020 like that. Okay, I am executing the report here. But how the date is coming here? See here 207.15. Something it is coming. Okay, this is invalid date here. Now I want to enter proper date. Okay, so here instead of D, you just pass the dots. Okay, data type, you just pass the dots, DATS. Dots or D, both are same here, but if you take dots, then what will happen? It will display the date with dot mean, like something today date is 25th, right? 25.07.2020, like that it will display. Okay, if you don't, otherwise if you pass like D, then how the date will display? 25.07.2020, there will be no dot. So if you want to divide the date in the dots, then we have to provide dots here. Save the program, check the program and activate the program, execute the program. See 20.7. something is coming. Okay, why it is coming like this? Okay, so actually the date will convert. For example, I will take one parameter. Let us see how the date will come. Parameter, parameter p underscore date, okay. Dots are SY-DATVM. This is one SY-DATVM. This is a system field, means SAP is providing this field. Okay, SAP is providing this field. See, my requirement is in the top of the program, when the program is displayed, okay, when the program is executed, that day I want to display. Okay, that day I want to display here. So that is why I am taking here some parameter. This is for your understanding purpose, p and square date. Okay, save the program, check the program and activate it. Okay, now I'm executing the program. It is asking the p and the square date. Okay, now I will give the date today, 25.07.2020. Okay, 25.07.2020, something date is coming here. Okay, now I want to execute the program in the debugging level. So I am giving here /h because this is the input screen. Okay, if you get any input screen, then if you want to execute the program in the debugging level, then you have to provide here /h. Click an enter button. You can see the message here, debugging switched on. Okay, now execute the program. Okay, so before going to our program, some predefined or some standard program is coming here. Okay, click an F7 button. Now our program came. Okay, this is our program. Click an F5 button and click on desktop tree. See, if I click on standard button, then what will happen? Here some PAI screen and PAI module, something event, like this it is coming. Okay, so some events, concepts, this PAI, these all things you will get in the further classes. Like module 2 program is there, so in that one you can see some PAI screen module like that. Events are coming. Okay, so we have some events. You can get those all events in reports concepts. Okay, RISIP is our concept, right? So in R is for reports. So at that time we can get the events. Okay, so in the top, the right side, the screen is dividing into two parts. Okay, in the left side, our code is coming. In the right side, it is divided into two parts once again. Okay, the top, it is showing some standard screens and something events like that. Okay, we don't want to see these all things down. And here, in the bottom, we can give the variables here. Okay, work area or internal table, how the values are flowing. If you want to get to know those variables or those work areas, internal tables, we can provide here, right? Now, if I want to provide more than three variables here, okay, this is not possible. We have to click on this down arrow mark. Okay, each and every time, okay, I am giving 10 variables. I want to get to know 10 variables here. For example, where is this one? Customer name is there. Okay, and customer number is there. Okay, and date, document date is there. Address, work area customer, IT customer. See, total I have given 5 inputs here, okay, in the right side screen. But if I want to see, above values, okay, I have to click on this up arrow mark, okay. Up arrow mark. If I want to see down values, then I have to click on down arrow mark. Okay, so it will be little bit difficult to click on down arrow mark and up arrow mark like that. So in the desktop tree, okay, click on desktop tree. How it will come? Only the values, only the variables will come here. Okay, only the variables will come. That is why most of the time we don't go for standard. Okay, standard is also okay. When we have to go to standard means, if you want to get to know any events, some events will come in our reports concept. Okay, at that time, if you want to get to know which event is executing at present, then we will go for standard. Okay, or maximum we will go for desktop 3 only. And you may ask, what is the use of desktop 2 and desktop 1? Just click on that one. See here, the desktop, the standard, the screen is dividing into two parts on the right side, right? The top screen is coming. Okay, if you want to display only top screen, okay, if you want to display only top screen, then we have to go for desktop 2. Okay, and desktop 1 also is there. Okay, the screen is dividing into horizontally it is dividing. Okay, horizontally it is dividing half of the screen for our code and half of the screen for our input variables. Okay, and here also it will be a little bit difficult to check the variables here. You can use this one also, no problem. But if you have more than three input fields, then we have to click on up arrow mark or down arrow mark like that. And the screen also, the program also, we cannot see properly. Okay, here it is displaying 10 lines of code. I am not able to see, 20, 30 lines of code at a place. Okay, so if we go for desktop 3, half of the screen is for our program and half of the screen for input variables. Okay, so desktop 1, 2, 3 standard. Okay, in these four things we will prefer desktop 3. And by what is the structure, tables, objects, we will discuss it later. Okay, one by one we will discuss. Okay, and now p underscore date is there, right? So what is the p underscore date? It is coming 20/20/07/25, but how I have given the input 25.07.2020, I have given the date. Okay, once again, I am executing this one. I will keep the breakpoint here. Execute the program. Okay, just execute the program and see, I am giving the date like something 10.05.2020, or here I will give 18.5.2020. okay, date dot month dot here I am giving. Okay, but if you check in the back end, in the debugging, how the value is converting for p and square date here. Okay, 20, 20, 05, and 18. There is no dots. Okay, how it is coming? Year. First of all, it is coming. It is converting like year 2020. Okay, after that one, it is converting to the month. After that one, date. Okay, this is the standard SAP date format. Okay, this is the standard SAP date format. Year, month, day. There is no dot slash, nothing is there. Okay, directly it is coming year, month, day. Okay, fine. Now, if you want to provide any data in the program level for the date, okay, then we are also, we have to provide in the same format. Okay, how the date is coming in the same format, even though you have given, you have given like date dot month dot year only. Okay, fine. But in the back end, the debugging, okay, the value is converting like year, month, day. Okay, so how the day is converting, how the date is converting in the same way we have to provide here. Okay, first of all, 2020 and 7 and 5 and 15. Okay, now click on F5 button. Document date is coming. See here, document date is 15/07/20, right? So 2020 I have given, but 2020 it is accepting. Click on edit mode. So how I will give 2020 and 07 and 15. Okay, this is the date format. Okay, year, month, day. Click on enter button. So I am overwriting this one. I am overwriting. I mean, I am changing the value in the debugging level. Okay, now click on apply button. So once again, 10.7.2020 is coming. I am converting this one in the debugging level. Okay, 2020, 07 and 10. Click on enter button. Okay, now click on F5 button. Okay, I am not changing this one. 12.7.20 is there, right? For the last record, I am not changing that one. And directly I am executing last button. Okay, see how the date is coming. 15.7.2020 and 10.7.2020 and 20. So I did not change for this one. That's why it is not coming in the correct way. Okay, so we are giving the input in the day dot month dot year. Okay, that is the input here. But in the back end, in the debugging screen, it is converting like year, month, day. Okay, and in the output, it is once again converting like day dot month dot year. Means input and output. Okay, input and output, it is displaying like day dot month dot year. Okay, in the back end, the debugging screen, the value is changing like year, month, day. Okay, you have to remember the date format here. Anyone is confusing in this date format? Or once again, I have to repeat it.
Please once repeat it, sir.
Okay. I am taking one parameter p underscore date. Okay, p underscore date is the parameter parameter, right? Okay, parameter p underscore date type dots, or you can take one system variable, that is SY-DATEM. Okay, like this is a standard field. SAP is providing this field. Okay, a data element also. Okay, and I am displaying that one. Write p underscore date. Okay, write p underscore date. Just I am taking one parameter and I am displaying that parameter for the date only. Okay, save the program. Activate it. Keep the breakpoint here. Execute the program. Okay, here I have to give the date. How you will give the date? 23.08.2020. Okay, this is our understandable date format. Okay, date dot month dot year. Okay, I am clicking an execute button. Okay, how the date is converting? We have to check that one. Okay, how the date is converting? See, if you see in the p underscore date. Okay, the date is changing. The date format is changing here. Okay, 2020-08-23. I'm giving like dd dot mm dot yy. Okay, in the input screen I'm giving the date format in this way. Okay, this is the input. Okay, but in the debugging level, okay, in the debugging level, in the back end, how it is changing, converting the format yy mm dd. This is the back end. Okay, I'm giving in this format. Okay, but it is converting into like this format. Okay, yyy mm dd. Okay, in the debugging screen it is converting in this format. Okay, now in the displaying, the displaying, how it will come? Just I'm displaying the data. Okay, just I'm displaying the date here. That's it. Click on F8 button. See how it is converting 23.08.2020 only. How we are giving the input? The same format. The same format. Output also coming. Okay, but in back end, the debugging screen, it is converting the format. Okay, date is same only. Date is not changing here. Date is same only, but the format is changing. Okay, so we have to. Sorry, this is the format. Okay, yyy mm dd. So this is the format. For display input and output the same format, but in the back end or in the debugging screen the format will change here. Is it okay, or anyone have any other doubts? Okay, see, and one more thing, I am taking one more variable here, data LVN square date type SI-DATEM. Okay, SI-DATEM LV underscore date. Okay, I am giving here in the program level. Okay, I am giving something date in the program level. Okay, if you are providing something date in the program level, okay, then we have to give like system format means yyyy mm dd. Okay, so I want to provide something date like 2020 and 07 and 25. So if someone want like 27/07/2020, so if you want in that particular format, so we have to divide. We have to divide day, month, year into different variables, and after that one we have to concatenate by using slash button. Okay, I will discuss it later. Okay, as of now, how the date is coming. How we are giving the input, how the output is coming, and how the value is converting in the debugging, you just concentrate on that thing. Okay, 25/07/2020, I will discuss about this one in the further classes. Okay, if I discuss all the things at a time, then you will get confused here. Okay, I will discuss it later. Okay, and I'm giving the date format LV underscore date equal to 2020-07-25. Okay, in the program level I'm giving the date in this format. Okay, and here write is there, right? P underscore date. sorry, it'll be underscore date, right? Okay, LV underscore date, just activate the program. Display errors. A spelling mistake. Check it. Activate it. So program is activated. So I am keeping the breakpoint here and execute the program. Okay. Here it is asking one more input here. Okay. Click on execute button. Two dates are there. Okay, one is P underscore date and one more is LV underscore date. Okay, LV underscore date I am giving in the program level. Okay, P underscore date I am giving in the input screen. Okay, so in the input screen I have given 19.01.2020, but it is converting like in this format. Okay, so here LV date is coming. LV date 2020-07-25. Click on F5 button. See, the value is coming like this. Okay, now click on execute button. All the date is coming same format 19.01.2020 and here 25.07.2020. Okay, so whenever you are providing, so if you want to provide any date in the program level, okay, in the program level, then we have to give like this year month date. Okay, this is the format to give the date in the program level. Okay, if you want to give the date in the input screen, okay, if you want to provide the date in the input screen, then you can follow our date format only, date dot month dot year, like that. And why we have to see in the write statement, now write statement we should not take like this. Okay, in the same line I am taking up to here, right? So if we take like that, then what will happen? Okay, just execute the program. Okay, just scroll down here. See how the values are coming. I want to click on customer number, customer name, customer document date. Okay, what is the remaining field here? I am not understanding here. Just scroll to right side. Okay, customer address, something is coming. So if something data is there, then we have to scroll to right side. Okay, but I am blocking I am not able to see the full screen here for the programming, right? So instead of this one, I will click an enter button here after first variable, and here also, and here also. Okay, in the debugging screen, how it will come? So in a single page only we can display this one, and we should not click on right side or left side like that. Okay, we have to just scroll down, that's it. Okay, directly we can double click on the field names, that's it. That's why we will give in this format. Okay, so after one variable or one field, we have to click an enter button. The second line we can write second one. Okay, mostly we will prefer in this way. And today's concept is we have to fetch the data from a table. Okay, I will create one more. 25.07.2020. Create. I want to display some TW01, that is the company information. I don't want this one. Click on OK button. Okay, now I want to declare one work area. How can I declare? Data begin of work area W I am taking. Okay, work area. This is the company code information, right? COMP. I'm taking COMP. Okay, in the shortcut. Okay, here company code. Okay, so company code information will available in the table of TW01. Go to TW01 table. Click on display button. Okay, here company code is the BUKRSP. Okay, and company name is the BUTXT. And city is the ORT01, country land one. Okay, these four fields I want to display. Okay, I just execute the program table. See here, company code, company name, and city, okay, and country. Okay, I want to pick these four columns. Okay, I want to pick these four columns from TW01 table, and I want to display in our program. Okay, that is our requirement now. So begin now, work area COMP. What is the first field here? Company code. Okay, company code. What is the field name here? BUKRS, right? So I will take here BUKRS only and type. Okay, type. What is the data element? BUKRS. Or the data type and length is the character 4. Okay, here I am taking C and the bracket 4 I am taking. Okay, directly I am declaring the data type and length here. Okay, and second one, what is the next field? BUTXT. Okay, BUTXT type. What is the data element for this one? BUTXT only. Okay, now I will declare the field with data element. Okay, next one, ORT01. Okay, ORT01. What is the data element? ORT01 only, but I will declare like table name hyphen ORT01. This is the field name here. Okay, table name hyphen field name. Okay, you can declare in multiple ways like this. Okay, directly you can provide data type and name, or by using data element we can declare, or table name hyphen field name we can declare. Okay, and land one. Last one is the land one type, TW01 hyphen land one. Okay, and end of work area COMP. Company I'm ending here. Okay, now I have to declare one internal table, data IT COMP, like table of work area COMP. Okay, one internal table and one work area declared now. Okay, so work area for it will store one record at a time. Okay, internal table means one by one we have to fill the internal table by using that work area. Okay, now I have to fetch the data. How can I fetch the data from the TW01 table? Okay, here some select queries are there. Okay, select queries, I am writing that one select. Okay, how many fields you want, that many of fields you have to write here. Okay, select bookers space BUTXT space ORT01 space and land one. Okay, these all are four columns here, bookers, BUTXT and ORT01 and land one. Okay, land one. So these are the four columns, and from which table you are fetching? Okay, from TW01 table. Okay, I am fetching bookers, BUTXT, ORT01, land one, from which table? From TW01 table. Okay, and you are fetching all four columns here. Okay, you are fetching four columns, and where you are keeping the data? I want to keep the data. Okay, I want to keep the data in this internal table, ITCOMP. Into table ITCOMP. Okay, I am selecting number of columns. How many columns you want? That many of columns. From which table? From T001 table. Okay, fine. I am fetching the information. Four columns I am fetching, and I am keeping. Where I am storing? I am storing in ITCOMP. Okay. Now I want to display the data. Now by using this select query, ITCOMP internal table will fill here. Okay. ITCOMP internal table will fill here. Now I want to display the data. How can you display the data? By using loop statement, because it may contain more than one record. Okay, if you want to display more than one record, then we have to loop that internal table. Loop at ITCOMP into Workaday.COMP. Okay, so I am looping ITCOMP internal table. Okay, fine. Whenever we are looping, at that time, one by one, record by record, first record, second record, third record, like that. Okay, first record will come to one work area. Okay, I am declaring the work area also. I am passing the work area name also here. Okay, and after that one, we have to display the data. Right, write statement and chain operator / work area COMP - bookers. Comma work area COMP - BUTXT comma work area COMP - ORT01 comma work area COMP - LAND1. Okay, now save the program, check the program. There is no problem. Now I will click an enter button. Okay, by looking wise also it will be good here. Okay, now save this one, activate it. There is no problem. Okay, now click on the keep the breakpoint here. Okay, now execute the program. Okay, execute the program. I am writing here on select query, right? Double click on this internal table name. Okay, 0 × 4 means 0 records are available and 4 columns are there in this internal table. Okay, 4 columns. Okay, bookers, BUTXT, ORT01, LAND1. 4 columns are there, but records are not available. 0 records are available. That is why 0 × 4 is coming here. Okay, now I am selecting. Okay, I am selecting something data from T001 table. Right, just click on F5 button. See here, 164 records are coming. Okay, 164 records. You have to cross check. Okay, you have to cross check. See here, 164 records are coming in the table level. Just go to the table. So this is the table, right? Execute the table here. Okay, check the contents. Number of entries are available here, right? Just click on that button. How many records are coming? 164. Okay. Total 164 are coming. Now you can execute this one also, no problem. See here, total 164 records are coming. You can see the number. Okay, so the data is correct. Okay, whatever we are fetching, the data is correct. 164 records are coming. You can double click on it. Okay, see here, company code is the 0001 SAP AG and something. You can cross check the data also. Okay, this is the table and this is the debugging screen. Okay, first record 0001 and here also 0001 SAP AZ. So same thing. Okay, it is displaying 4 columns here. Okay, 4 columns. Okay, now click on back button. Here loop statement is coming. I want to display the data, right? So it is displaying something. I am writing something loop statement. Okay, so what is the use of loop statement? One by one we have to read the data. Okay, one by one, we have to read the data. Here 164 records are coming. So I'm clicking an F5 button. So work area COMP is coming. Double click on that one. Okay, the work area COMP, the company code is 0001. Means this is the first record of the internal table. You can see here. Okay, 0001 SAP AC is coming. This is the first record of internal table. And you can see the number S5-FN Tabex is coming. Okay, what is the number? I mean looping number. I mean which record the internal table is looping here? Okay, first record is looping. Okay, now I want to display the data. Okay, so I'm skipping this one. See second time. Okay, now I'm in S5-FN Tabex equal to 2. Okay, S5-FN Tabex equal to 2. Here work area COMP is coming. Here the bookers, the company code. Okay, company code is 0005. Okay, you can check in the internal table also what is the second record. Second record is 0005 only. Okay, so in this way it will loop here. I am clicking an F8 button. See the red here, some breakpoint is there, right? Okay, so I am clicking on F8 button. Okay, fine. I will discuss about this area button after some time. Otherwise, you will get confused here. Okay, directly I'm executing. See how the data is coming. So the data is coming in this way. Okay, but my requirement is I want to display company code information. Okay, which belongs to India. Okay. India. See here, country code is coming here. DE means this is the